All right, welcome to today's Simplicity Specialty Training. Today's training is on managing custom fields. In Simplicity, you do have the ability to create custom fields if there's not a stock field available for you to use. So for example, we have bank account name and some other bank account information here. These are fields that are not available in Simplicity as stock fields, so you'll have to create them. When you create your fields, they can look kind of jumbled, they can be out of order. So what we can do then is we can go to Settings and Custom Fields Admin. Okay, this is going to show us all of our custom fields. And you can see here they're in reverse alphabetical order, so it just goes from the top down that way. One thing you can do to organize your custom fields is to create sub-tab groups. Okay, so you can see we've got a couple sub-tab groups in here. What sub-tab groups do is organize your custom fields into different tabs. So if we go and take a look at the account really quick. Currently we have three sub-tabs. We have General, Info, and Skip Trace Info. Okay. So if we click on Skip Trace Info, we've got this one field under this particular tab. That means that it was placed under a sub-tab through Custom Fields Administration. Okay, so we've got one under Info as well. The rest are under General. If at any time anybody needs me to slow down or if you have any questions, please feel free to let me know. We're going to go to Settings and back to Custom Fields Administration. Okay, so that is one way to organize your your custom fields is into sub-tab groups. The other way to do this is to click on Edit Custom Fields. Can everybody see that link there? If I click on this, it brings up an additional box. And this is Custom Account Fields Ordering. So you can change the order. So if I want property address to be the first thing in my claim details page as a custom field, I can put that to the top. Okay, these are separated into two sections based on the account, the part of the claim details screen that they are on. So account section is the top portion of your claim details page. The debtor section is all of the fields that are in the debtor section of that page. So all of the debtor information such as name, date of birth, address, phone number, that's the debtor section of the account. So you have two sections where you can add a custom field and also where you can order them. So for example, if I want all of my bank account information to be together, okay, so I'll put bank account info at the top and I'm going to find my other bank account field. Okay, so now my bank account information should show together. Okay, you can also change the number of columns that you see. So across going left to right, right now we have it listed as 5 columns. We change this to 4 columns. We'll change this to 4 columns as well. We can click Save. And we'll go back to the account and take a look at how that looks. All right, so as you can see, this is the order that we've changed it to. We have bank account name first, bank info next, and we've switched it to 4 columns going across rather than 5. Any questions? Okay, any questions about how to create a sub-tab group for your custom fields? Any questions about how to reorder your custom fields after they've been created? All right, if there are no questions, that concludes today's specialty training. I'll allow another minute or so for questions, and then we'll go ahead and stop the recording.
Can you send a link to that?
This training will be posted on our YouTube page. We do have a YouTube page that includes all of our past specialty trainings as well as a new account training if you ever need a refresher. So it will be listed on that page.
Okay, and what is the YouTube address page, or do you have the link for that?
Let me get your PIN number, and I will send
sure.
that information to you.
Perfect. I would appreciate that. 522.
Okay. 522. And your name?
Brian.
Brian, perfect. All right, I will get that sent to you.
Thank you very much.
No problem. Thank you.